So let me check other problem. Just I will read out and try to understand what has been given. A hexagonal plane of side 30 mm has an edge on the HP. Its surface is inclined at 45 degrees to the HP, and the edge on which the plane rests is inclined 30 degrees to the vertical plane. Draw its projection. Projections mean to meet the conditions, the final front view as well as the top view. So as in a discussion, so anyway, the problem as you're reading itself, you have to try to just make the structural steps based on the conditions they're giving. So any problem, you have to observe the resting condition whenever it is inclined to both the plane, so that you can initiate the primary view. So you begin at the right direction initial step, so automatically it leads to the your solution end in the proper way. Any problem, first resting condition. So what the condition has been given? The plane has given hexagon, that means six sides, so each side of 30 mm. After that, resting condition HP, it is resting in horizontal plane. You have to make the sequence of steps. HP resting means HP projection to be drawn first. So edge resting means edge to be drawn perpendicular. The fix your first step. After that, identify the remaining data so that you can proceed in the sequence of steps. So what has been given? Surface is inclined 45 degrees to the HP, and the edge on which the plane rests is 30 degrees to the vertical plane. After that, many drafter, the alignment to be checked. So such that the edge of the drafter to be coincident with the drawing sheet, and draw the XY reference line first. Now observe condition. The condition has been given such that the edge is resting. The primary edge must be drawn perpendicular. So the what is the side length given? The side length has been given as the 30 mm. So draw the 30 mm perpendicular. So after that, hexagon mean you know that the angle of inclination side to side. So what the angle of inclination given? Angle of inclination is 30 degrees. So take protractor for the angular measurement. So just align properly such that the edge to be coincide with this. So after that one, where the edge you are taking? The count to be taken from the opposite side, don't confuse. Any confusion leads systematically to the wrong only. So here edge mean opposite 0. So here systematically count. So angle should be 120 degrees, and then just fix the angular direction. Similarly, other end, just try to do completely at the same time. Place again count from here, and just direction of angle is 120 degrees. Just mark the direction. After drawing the marking direction, so then take the scale. Why? Because angle should be same. At the same time, the side lengths also same. So in the direction of angular measurement, so take measured length of 30 mm. The since the side length has been given 13. 1, 2, 3. So 30 mm in the direction. The same other end also in the direction of 120 degrees angle. Just measure the length of 30 mm. So next thing, the same step we can continue. So take the protractor, at this end again you have to construct the angle of 120 degrees line. So place the protractor at the other end, again count from here. So 90, 100, 110 and 120 is the direction of angle. Same similarly, at this end also you have to mark. So place the protractor properly. So then just read 120 degrees. So now along the direction of lines, along the direction of angles, you have to draw the side lengths are same. So in this the direction of 120 degrees, measurement must be same length of 30 mm. Complete accuracy depends on your primary figure. So take care and draw properly the same of 30 mm. Again here also in the direction of the 120 degrees angle. So what is the measure length of the same 30 mm? The same, it is a regular volume. So other side automatically you can finish. So why? Because the only the ends to be connected by joining both the ends. So now please everything you have labeled properly. So let I am A, this is a B, this is a C, and this is a D, and this is a E, and this is a F. So once you have completed, just transfer to get the other side. You have to transfer all the points. Why? Because we know that front to top will be same line. So from every reference of the corners, you have to take with the help of mini drafter. I can finish. The since it is the A, we can just check their other side. So which is of visible. The when you are observing this side, A, B, C are nearer to us. those are visible points. So A dash, B dash, C dash, D is the behind, so mention in the bracket, E also behind, main bracket, F also in the behind, mention in the brackets. So now just connect this one, A to C, so which is gives the respective front view. So but this one as an assumption of our primary position. So what I need as per the problem condition, it has to be rest in HP. We know that front view is the details of the horizontal plane. One of the edges in HP. So take one of the edge. Edge mean two points representing. So A dash in the brackets F dash. Here to here dimensionally no change. We have to add the only the inclination. So what the inclination has been given? So for that we can just check the problem has been given. The surface is making 45 degrees to the horizontal plane. Whenever there is a two inclination, there is a confusion which has to be just take the position in the next level. This is the first one. In the sequence you are taking the second one. Always the latest view to be shifted. Whenever inclination with the one plane, we are not getting the any confusion. Why? Because so once you are getting alternate only the one angle, you can just shift to the new position with the given angle and you can get the final view. But whenever that there is a two angles, whether I have to shift this view or this view, so there is a confuse. So to avoid that one, you have to just keep in mind it has to be moved in the sequence. The first one, second one, the third one is the latest one to be drawn. So I am just located in that concern. So now the same length to be drawn with the angle of 45 degrees. So wherever the matter of angle comes, just take the protractor and place the weight point. You want to measure the angle. So along that one, 45 degrees I need. Just I am drawing 45 degrees line. But in that direction of angle, what the measurements to be represented? The same dimension, so whatever we did here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 52 mm we are getting. The same 52 mm measurement to be drawn along the direction of 45 degrees. So this is the angle of direction. So measure 52 mm from the point of reference. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 52, this is it. So now the corresponding points, the same points we can observe here, it is at a distance of 26. So again you have to fix midpoint itself to locate the middle points. So locate 1, 2, this one 26. Now A dash, this midpoint represents B dash as well as E dash. This point represents C dash as well as D dash. So once you are taken in the new position with the one of the condition mentioned in the problem, the surface is making 45 degrees in the horizontal plane. The respective view to be drawn by considering the front view, top view always in the same line. So for that one, so with the help of the mini drafter, I have to draw the projector lines very light by taking the 2H pencil. From every point of reference where I need, you have to draw. Along these lines, I know that A should be here, B should be on this side, C should be on this, but where exactly? So for that, you have to take the cross reference again from the previous view, take the mini drafter. So mini drafter lines to be drawn by coinciding the line of references. So from every point of reference, draw the projector lines. Now identify each point of reference. The A and A dash where intersecting, that is the location of A. B and B, both we are intersecting, that is the location of B. The C dash and C, the D dash and D, E dash and E, F dash and F. So once I am getting all the points to be get connected by the straight lines. In the polygons, all the sides are straight edges. Based on that one, you have to connect in the same sequence A to B, B to C, C to D and D to E, E to F. We are able to get the corresponding top view with the inclination of HP. So now we are able to just get one of the conditions satisfied. Edges in HP, surface is making 45 degrees. But what the other condition as mentioned in the problem is it clearly mentions that so what the edge resting that should be made 30 degrees to the vertical plane. But considering here, this is the edge resting AF, but it is perpendicular to the vertical plane. We need, it must be made 30 degrees with the vertical plane. So for that one, in the next stage, you have to take the 30 degrees reference line. Along the 30 degrees reference line, have to shift this one as it is dimensionally so that I can just make the condition of the problem. So now wherever you require, take the protractor for the angular measurement, measure 30 degrees line. Along the 30 degrees line, you have to reference lines to be drawn. In this one, which has to be made 30 degrees? This side which is resting AF, that should be made that one. The primary first, you have to align that first. So I am locating F somewhere. Let I am locating the F here. The correspondingly measure the distance. The same side length is 30 mm. I am aligning primary side. So now we cannot construct here directly as it is. But because it is a true shape, whenever the panel, I am getting every dimensions are same. But when the surface is inclining, all the dimensions get foreshortened. I cannot construct by considering the each side-to-side angle as a 120 degrees, which requires a polygon. Whatever you are getting, that only you have to consider. That means simply you have to transfer the points correspondingly. How the points can be transferred? So for that one, logically you will observe the geometrical condition. How the geometrical condition? From this A, AC is exactly perpendicular at particular distance. Yet F, the D point is exactly perpendicular away equal to this distance. So measure this distance, how much I am getting. So it is around 30, 1, 2, 3. So we are getting around 37. The same 37 mm, it should be made perpendicular. How the perpendicular will be made? So for that one, please use mini drafter so that I can comfortably. So one of the line reference we know, to that reference line, I need perpendicular. So just align the scale of your mini drafter to that one. So since it is a measure distance of 30 mm, so bring your mini drafter there and measure the length of 37 mm. 10, 20, 30, 37 here. Similarly here, measure the distance 10, 20, 30, 37 here. So that I am getting the F point. The since it is a A point, opposite to A, we are having the C point. Opposite to the F, I am having the D point. So once I am locating, I can just join the points D and C. I am getting the D and C. So you have to transfer this one. So how this point can be transferred? The same you can measure this distance geometrically, all are equal. Okay, with the help of the compass, I can measure the distance and I can just draw the arc from this end. I can draw the arc to intersect that side. I can draw the arc here, I can draw the arc here. So that is the one way of measurement. So otherwise, so being if the compass is not available, in such case how to transfer. So in that case, you know that this is the, again this line parallel to this one and just passing from the mid distance. And exactly it will be mid span of this one. We know that it is of the 37 mm. So mid span to be identified, you can transfer on either side the total length. So for that I can take again the construction help. So I can just add the mid span 30 mm in 15 mm. I have to measure 37 approximately. At this 18, you should have the measured length. So what the measured length should be? On either direction you can take the equal distance. So for that one, I can measure the distance here also. So that the same corresponding points I can transfer. So at this point, this is the midpoint I am locating here. The distance measured, how much? Either the direction I can measure here. 10, 20, 29. So here 10, 20, you are getting approximately 29 mm. So that means from this one, this is the mid span we are identifying. Around 36 mean, so around 18 mm. Around 18 mm, the span of you are getting 29. And you have to get on either direction same length. Parallel to here, 29 mm, 10, 20, 29 you are getting. Similarly, 10, 20, 29 you are getting. So automatically I am getting the point A, B, C, D, this is the E. Now take the scale and just finish that one. I can simply join the lines. So now simply I transfer. So with the condition, resting condition for H, whatever they giving, HP resting is making 30 degrees with the vertical plane. Now accordingly, it's the corresponding position. To complete that figure, we know the basic concept everywhere we are using. So that is nothing but front view, top view always in the same line. So for that, just extend the XY reference line. After that, we need projector lines. Projector lines nothing but it should be drawn very line, so which you are transferring from the respective points. So now from every corner of reference, I have to just simply extend. So by taking the mini drafter, this must be please use. You can just trust only mini drafter. The scale never guarantees to get a parallel line. So just please use mini drafter that way. So after that, along this line references, where those points will be exactly located. So for that one, you have to take the cross reference. So for the cross reference, again use the mini drafter from the respective previous view, that is the front view. Just extend the lines so that you can identify the corresponding points by observing the respective interprojectors. So that's why please labeling from the initial stage itself. Those points can be carried further. You can identify the points without any confusion. So for that one, I want to just identify the point. So let's taking the corresponding points. So let this is the A point, A dash. Both where are getting, so that I can corresponding A dash. So this is the B projector and B dash projector, where getting, that is a B dash. Again C and C dash is a C dash. Again the projector D and projector D dash is here the new D dash. Again E and E, both we are getting is the E dash. And F point, both corresponding getting the F dash. So once you are getting the points, those all the points can be joined in sequence so that I can get the final required view. Take the scale for that purpose, and you can just connect every point in the same order. So that is A to B, again B to C. So like in the same sequence to be predicted. A to B, B to E, again C to D, D to E, E to F, and F to A. So what are the condition of the problem? The 30mm hexagon resting with one of edging HP inclines 30 degrees with the VP, surface making 45 degrees with the HP. We drawn this all the points parallel to this one, automatically the surface is also making 45 degrees in the horizontal plane. Edge resting is making 30 degrees. So this is the way off you have to do. The initial you begin, automatically you just end in the right direction. Only the thing keep mind. So based on your resting condition, you can initiate that one. And can just you can finish your solution by drawing the dimension lines also. Just draw the extension line properly and just leaving the approximately gap and just draw the arrowhead and rinse 30 mm, you can draw that. So this is the solution for the problem.